Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, Joel Skousen, Marine Corps fighter pilot, aviator from the Vietnam era. Best-selling author, researcher. His uncle, of course, Cleon Skousen, wrote The Naked Communist, really one of the seminal works exposing how the ultra-rich use communism and socialism as a political tool of slavery. And, of course, he's the editor-in-chief of World Affairs Brief. You know, four or five days ago, I said, I want to get him on. And it was about Russia, and it was about the economy, and it was about China threatening to nuke the U.S. and the sellout of our technology. And I can't even remember why I wanted to get him on now. I mean, there was one particular reason. It'll pop in my head in a moment. But the point is, he can speak to all the stuff that's going on in the world. And then I can go over the news with him about what's happening in the world, how the entire neocon slash liberal combine wants open borders, what the plan is with that, and where he thinks we are societally. Again, we have him via Skype, and we'll also be going back and forth with phone when his Skype drops. Joel Skousen, thank you for coming on with us. Oh, his Skype dropped as well. I tell you, Joel's just awesome, but sometimes he's got technical issues. But hey, it's the wonder of technology that we can even talk to somebody at a distance. So that's always good. I'm sure we want to get the message across to him to be on phone and Skype at the same time. That's the key. But I'll talk to him during the break. But we'll be discussing that with Joel Skousen. By the way, I should mention this to everybody. The subscription side of InfoWars magazine has been very, very successful. But it's really a tool just to get bulk magazines out. And that was so much more successful. If you didn't subscribe last month, you will never get a subscription to this. We're not going to get rid of it in 12 months. We're going to continue with the bulk making of it. I love the magazine. It's very successful. But you know, having 12 shipping it 12 times, that was like more than half the cost paying for the shipping each time, because you can't get media mail in a newspaper or a magazine. And so, you know, even at $39.95, 12 issues delivered, it's just so much more inexpensive to sell these in bulk. I mean, we can ship you 10 of these at cost for a little bit more than it would be to have the subscription each month. So that's what we're doing. Get it. It's a big glossy color magazine. The February issue is out. And then you've got a big double cover glossy magazine full of the most important articles of the month and original articles. This one deals with the heart and soul of the police and the battle by the globalists to turn them into third world enforcer thugs, and our battle to try to wake them up, how the police can be devils or angels, and how the globalists are trying to turn them to the dark side, how we need to fight to take back control of our police from the feds themselves that have been captured by the globalists. And there's a bunch of other key articles and letters to the editors and so much more in the magazine. But this is, again, a very important issue dealing with the police throughout it that I'm really, really, really proud of. And it's great to give police that you know. It's almost kind of like an Officer Jack McClam, Vampire Killer 2000, 2.0, showing good things police are doing and examples of good police versus examples of the militarization of police that the globalists have basically created. So I'm very proud of the 64-page magazine. It doesn't just get into the police and the militarization of police worldwide. It gets into DHS, gave Muslim Brotherhood, VIP treatment, no TSA pat-downs. It's got, oh, my favorite, the giant double America spread with Leanne McAdoo holding twin 50 calibers. Pretty strong girl bill to do that. With just pure Americana in the background. Absolutely sure to, it's America, not America, America. Got the bald eagle landing there. This is just pure Americana. If you show a trendy this, or a socialist this, or a so-called feminist this, we're torturing feminists, fake feminists since 1995. This will send them into convulsions of anger. And there's just so much so much more. The Radiation Report, it's all in here. InfoWarsStore.com.
The facts are in. The studies are legion. Sodium fluoride and other toxic members of the fluoride family are devastating the health and cognitive ability of the American people. So why are the social engineers adding it to the water? Simple. Dumb down the host population that the parasitic technocracy is feeding on. We may not have been able to get fluoride out of the water supply yet, but we can help to get it out of our bodies. I am extremely excited to announce the exclusive InfoWars Life Fluoride Shield formula. Fusing six of the best documented ingredients from around the world to help the body remove not just toxic fluoride residues from the body, but a whole host of toxic substances. Let's take a stand against the globalist by blocking their poisons with Fluoride Shield. I use Fluoride Shield every day. Secure your Fluoride Shield and other pioneering formulations at InfoWarsLife.com today. Let's start cleansing our bodies now and support the InfoWar at the same time. That's InfoWarsLife.com. Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee. And it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com. In the last 50 years, iodine has been phased out of our staple foods and replaced with the halogen bromine, a practice now banned in nations around the world. Guess what else is in the halogen family? Fluoride. Ladies and gentlemen, Alex Jones here. In 1924, the federal government did the right thing and encouraged salt producers to add iodine. It's the good halogen on the periodic table. And the results are on record, reports documented, a 15-point IQ increase in areas that had previously been deficient in iodine. Bottom line, iodine is important. Unbound, clean, in a glycerin base, nascent iodine was the answer for myself and my family. You will find Survival Shield Nascent Iodine exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWars Life Survival Shield Nascent Iodine isn't just for emergencies. I take it every day. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
I wanted to get Joel Skousen on last week because I was rereading over The Naked Communist on Wikipedia that has the goals of communism. And when a lot of the Soviet archives got declassified in the 90s, indeed, these were official communist goals that Cleon Skousen, his uncle, was able to get. So I wanted to get him on about this because when you see the Grammys with multiple satanic rituals going on, and I know some of the people involved, they're very serious. Lady Gaga, all of them actually believe they're being attacked by demons. I mean, these people, whether you believe it's real or psychological, it's still an archetype. They're manifesting this mental illness. And other authoritarian regimes are always occult-driven. Hitler was into the occult, the Babylonians, the Egyptians, the Romans. They serve the same archetype. Even if you don't believe in God, they are manifesting the same spirit. So it's real one way or the other. And, of course, I know it's spiritual. Now, we've got his nephew on, who's an author, and, of course, former Marine Corps fighter pilot in the Vietnam era, heads up worldaffairsbrief.com, Joel Skousen, via Skype and phone. In case either one cuts out, you'll hear different audio quality back and forth today. He joins us because I wanted to get him on in the first half of the hour about the communist goals and how mega rich fund communism and socialism as a tool of control, because people get confused by that. Why does George Soros fund socialism and communism? Why did the New York banks fund the Bolshevik Revolution on record? That was in congressional testimonies and came out in documents in multiple committees. What are the big foundations up to? Capture both of the political parties in the United States. Use technical decisions of the courts to weaken basic American institutions by claiming their activities violate civil laws. Use fake civil rights to trump basic human rights and God-given rights. Get control of the schools. Use them as the transmission belts for socialism and current communist propaganda. Soften the curriculum. Use student riots to foment public protest. Infiltrate the press. Get control of book reviews. Continue discrediting American culture. And now it's been declassified. The CIA would put out decadent art to then basically then discredit beautiful art. And again, now you turn on any children's show, any movie, it's meant to sell you on ugliness, to where now anything good and pure, it's not enough to accept gays now. No, being straight is bad, we're told in the news. You see it everywhere. And again, this is done as the subversion program. First they want to subvert, then they want to basically undermine the society. They want to collapse the society and then reorganize it. So we are literally seeing saboteur operations going on. And then you understand these are not liberals, folks. They knew Obamacare would hurt poor people. They knew it would bankrupt the country. They want full control. They hate the masses. Communists at the top are never really communists. They are banker technicians conning the unwashed masses. So I wanted him to break down the program that came out that they've now discredit the American founding fathers. That's number 30. Present them as selfish aristocrats who had no concern for the common man when it was the opposite. They hadn't fully realized these dreams, but they were the first to really put it in paper and move it forward. And so he joins us now to talk about that. Then at the bottom of the hour, I want to get into the geopolitical outlook, the economy, the Russians, the Chinese, what's happening in the Middle East, the major buildup for continued authoritarianism, but the huge awakening we see unfolding with Joel Skousen. And when I told him I wanted you on a few days ago, I hope they relayed that it was about this, but I know you're an expert on it, so you can speak to it. But now, who can deny they're trying to undermine culture and any good institutions so they can collapse them and bring in a total takeover? Joel Skousen.
Well, thanks, Alex. It's good to be with
you. It's good to be with you.
One of the things that I want to point out at the inception here, as I've gone through the 45 goals that Clayton extracted from communist writings, it's important to realize that you won't find this listed anywhere in communist literature. In other words, this was in bits and pieces from various different communist writers at the time, and actually only about half of them have come true. And what's most interesting, and you've mentioned some of those especially, and I might mention, getting UN recognition for Red China, replacing Taiwan was a communist goal, doing away with all loyalty oaths, resisting any attempt to outlaw the Communist Party. All those have been done. Russia access, continued access to the U.S. Patent Office. They did not, however, able to capture both political parties, that is, for the Communist Party. They were not able to get control of the schools, per se. But the schools have been under the control of what we would call globalists. And this is the most interesting thing about what's happened, is that when I look at the list of what they were able to accomplish out of these 45 goals, the half that approximately that were able to be achieved were not achieved by communists, but they were achieved by non-communists, globalists and socialists and leftists and liberals in the United States, who all share the same philosophy.
That's the key, is that the Carnegie Endowment and the Ford Endowment, as you know, had helped fund the Bolshevik Revolution and all the rest of it. So it wasn't that they were imitating the communists. It was that they had been the progenitors of that movement going back even to the 1850s as a way to control rebellions by serfs against one form of slavery. They were now going to bring in another. And so the Russians and the KGB and others were actually working for some of the same goals as the Western establishment, as Carol Quigley wrote.
And for example, on the infiltration of the press, I mean, you know, in the 40s, and there were quite a few communists in the press.